Well, praise God, we have made it to the finish line. And like so many of you in the field of education, but we also in HF have made it to the end of our program year. Whoa! You know, one of my favorite verses in the Bible is from Proverbs chapter 19, verse 21. And you may still have this bookmark where it says that many are the plans in a man's heart, but the purpose of the Lord will prevail. And as we look back over this past year, that is what we want to celebrate, what God has done in and through HIF, even despite or because of this current pandemic. So many around the world, our plans have been greatly disrupted. Yet God has continued to work and His purpose has continued to prevail in HIF. HIF's purpose is to glorify God among the nations through Christ-centered worship, genuine relationships, and transformational outreach. Well, for us at HIF, our purpose is our bottom line. Every staff meeting and every elders meeting, we ask ourselves this question: how has God been glorified among the nations? Well, today we want to celebrate how God has been faithful and how His perfect timing has been so good during these past few months, this past year. And we want to do that by highlighting a few stories that demonstrate how God has been at work in our worship, in our relationships, and in our outreach. But first, I want to start with praising God for receiving our registration at the start of our program year. Just this past July, we received from the government the registration of HIF as an independent international church. We are no longer depending on a national denomination, but can directly relate to government and other institutions. Also, the government is providing visas for our pastoral staff, and this is such a great milestone in HIF's history. So let's give him a clap. Give God an applause. And personally, I praise God that during this past year, I was able to publish my book, Love Your City. Since we started the Love Hanoi campaign 7 years ago, and during my doctoral research during the same period, I've been able to develop 5 steps to citywide movements, which I'm telling in this book, as well as my personal journey, the HIF history, and the story of Love Hanoi itself. You can get this book online at your favorite bookstore, or after the service, copies will be available for you as well. Not only that, during this past few months, the Vietnamese translation has been completed, and we're now just finishing the editing, and hopefully later this year, we will be able to publish this book legally here in country. So pray with me for that to be completed. As we started this program year, I shared with you on Vision Sunday that we anticipate to collaborate with sending agencies to place workers in Hanoi to work with HIF. Well, exactly 1 year ago this week, Linda and I met up with Steve and Suzanne in Waco, Texas. It was during that visit that God affirmed His call for them to join HIF on staff. And so watch and listen as Steve and Suzanne tell their own story.
It was 2019 and we were having lunch with Jakob and Linda at the Magnolia Cafe in Waco, Texas, when Linda said, "You should try on Hanoi."
What she meant was that we'd been praying about the different opportunities we had, where we should go, and we just weren't feeling any clarity. And Linda and Jakob said, "Well, we feel clarity, and you should just try on Hanoi in your head, and after a day or two, it'll become clear if this is where you're supposed to go or not." So we did, and we went to bed that night, continued to pray, woke up the next morning, and we both looked at each other and said,
We're moving to Hanoi. But actually, the story starts a few years earlier, back in 2018, when I was here in Hanoi at the MICN conference. It was about day 3, it was late in the afternoon, and there was kind of a throwaway session that Pastor Jakob and Pastor Nelson were having. And at the end of the session, Pastor Nelson says to Pastor Jakob, he says, "Jakob, what you need is a 50-year-old guy whose kids are finished with college, university, and who comes with full support." And I thought, I was 50.
Kind of specific?
Yeah, I was 58 at the time. Our daughter was 6 months away from graduating from university, and we had full support, and we knew that our time in Africa was going to come to a close. Mm-hmm. God had released us from that, and we were looking for the next place to serve. So I spoke to Jakob afterwards, and then he set me up with Pastor Jason, and we had a great lunch, and then we came here for an interview. Mm-hmm. But that's not the only place we interviewed. Where else did we interview?
During our time of looking, we interviewed in Mauritius, in Amman, Jordan, in Beirut, here in Hanoi, and then in Colorado Springs. And for all of them, either the doors kind of closed unexpectedly, or we were offered a position and we prayed about it and God said, nope.
Nope.
And so we just really weren't sure what to do, because at the end, before we met them for lunch, the last open job offer was with HIF, and we just weren't feeling clarity.
Yeah, so we didn't want to move unless God moved with us. And so that night we went home, mm-hmm. we prayed,
and
went to sleep, tried on Hanoi, and said, we're moving to Hanoi.
Yeah. So we came in September. I'm helping out with administration in the office. I've been running a women's Bible study. It's, as it turned out, God's timing that we came at this time, because Marion is away in the Philippines and has kind of gotten stuck in the Philippines. So I'm able to be here and take over some of her responsibilities.
And I've just been doing administration also, but more on the pastoral side, and teaching the Equipped Leadership Development course for emerging leaders, mm-hmm. and doing some preaching, but also just getting to know and understand the mm-hmm. culture of an evangelical church called Hanoi International Fellowship. So we're happy to be here, happy to serve God in this place.
Well, I'm so thankful that Steve and Suzanne have joined the team in support of HIF's purpose. And as an outcome of that purpose, it is our prayer that God transforms lives of people who come from all over the world to Hanoi for this time. Discipleship is ongoing at HIF. So many people are involved unnoticed, but I want to say thank you for all those who are doing discipleship in HIF. Well, one intentional way of doing discipleship is celebrate recovery. And this past year, we launched the Celebrate Recovery group here in HIF, and I'll let Jody tell you the story.
Hello, church. My name is Jody. So I just want to give you an update on what God's doing in and through Celebrate Recovery. So we've been meeting the past 32 weeks. We started off with 4 core people and have grown to almost 30 now. So just excited to see that everyone, even through the isolation time, was serious about getting recovery and returning to the CR family. During the isolation time, there were 6 weeks where we did it online. Right now we have 3 step studies going on. A step study is a 24-week process. They get together in their gender-specific groups and then go through the 12 steps and into their past to look at what the root causes of some of their pain is and find healing through the vehicle of the 12 steps and power of the Holy Spirit. At Bethesda Rehab Center, we have also started a pilot project where we've implemented the Celebrate Recovery material in order to help these guys in their healing journey. We're hoping by this fall, HIF will be able to offer CR in a bilingual manner. Pastor Jakob was able to meet with the government officials and the police of the Westlake area and told them about Celebrate Recovery, and they're really excited to see something like this offered in the Westlake area. One of our hopes in this is through all the training and all the healing in this process that HIF can become a training hub for Vietnam and maybe for all of Asia. That people can come here, learn the process, participate, find healing from their hurts, habits, and hangups, and able to take this back into their churches and abroad.
Well, Celebrate Recovery is not only a discipleship tool, it also provides an opportunity for outreach. Well, speaking of outreach, we could have never anticipated the opportunity we had during this COVID-19 season. Most of you know that we distributed $7,000 worth of resources to 3 local hospitals, including the Back My Hospital. But you may not know the backstory of how we built that relationship with Back My Hospital. And I'll let Peter tell you this story.
I am Peter Mazuka. I've owned my own painting business as a painting contractor for 35 years, doing commercial and residential projects. My grandfather was a master plumber, and I learned from him plumbing, and I also taught myself how to do a variety of other home repairs. With my plumbing experience, I've always wanted to help others when I could. Right before coming to Vietnam, I had an accident and I hurt my back. The next day, I went for a bike ride, not knowing my bike was in such a complicated position that I had fractured my spine. And I'm a climber. I love endurance riding, and I've ridden bikes for 35 years. I can remember riding bikes to the mountains of USA and in France. And I've also ridden 108 miles in one day, is my longest ride. I wanted to serve God through outreach, so I planned my move to Vietnam. My church in Texas wrote to Pastor Jacob. When I arrived in Vietnam, I went to the Westlake congregation and I stated that I came here to serve. After service, Pastor Jacob told me about opportunities how to serve. He advised me that I should use my English administrative skills to love Hanoi. I began teaching Spotlight English. At that time, a little bit later, I was informed by HIFR about a medical practitioner service looking for one-on-one English tutors to doctors. He gave me a number to call. Dr. Chi called me, and I met him later with his wife, and he eventually became my student. During one of our lessons, I shared with him my story about my spine injury. He shared the story with his wife. His wife is a head deputy nurse at Bach Mai Hospital, and that is how Bach Mai connection with HIF started, because they showed me care for my personal condition and pain and suffering. The opportunity to serving through outreach came to me. City Partners Ministry is a HIF ministry that I serve. While serving, we worked with Healing Hearts Vietnam and was able to introduce them to Bach Mai Hospital. Healing Hearts was looking for partners and were eager to expand their operation in Hanoi. And doctor's wife introduced me to the Vice Deputy Director of Bach Mai Hospital, and we discussed hosting a team of surgeons from the USA. After 2020 New Year, these doctors came to Hanoi and trained medical students and staff at Bach Mai Hospital. And they screened children suffering from heart disease with their equipment and offered financial help to pay for their life-saving treatment, which also included a budget for food and medication for the patients and their families. During the COVID-19 pandemic, because of the connection with Bach Mai Hospital, I was able to ask the needs of the doctors, the nurses, and their patients, and HIF was able to reach out to support them by providing them with needs which extended to the Children's Hospital, as well as the Military Hospital, where HIF already have a connection and a relationship. HIFers have had the posture to truly love Hanoi, bringing Jesus to strangers. This is an evangelical church movement, being the church in this city. We truly demonstrate genuine relationships. Praise be to God.
Well, it's people like Peter who we want to celebrate today, who simply want to serve God and love others. And there's many like him in HIF. And even though we cannot highlight everyone, I especially want to highlight the worship and media team. During the period of isolation, many of us could just sit back on the couch, turn on the TV, and watch and worship together online. But it's the worship and media team that made all this possible. And I'll let Tommy tell you this story.
Many churches were not prepared for the COVID-19 season, as the lockdown happened quicker than expected. I remember projecting in my home studio what the next service would look like. We had quickly transitioned from a 100% congregated service to a 100% online service, which meant that most of the operation would be on my team. We had an amazing time learning and growing together in the worship and media team. We were able to support the children ministries, connect group meetings, online prayer and giving. We even recorded sermons in the fields and on the streets of Hanoi. We had produced over 240 videos in these past 8 weeks. All those videos went out through our YouTube and Facebook channels. One major highlight was the Easter Sunday service this year. It was the first time we ran Easter Sunday service fully online. It was a major work, but we're so thankful that God made it possible. And here are some testimonies from the team members.
It is my first time to run a service in the middle of the week. And the team that I have in HIF has been a blessing to me. They taught me a lot of things, especially technicalities and all this stuff that I must learn since I'm doing the PowerPoint. And yeah, HIF is such a blessing.
Durant la période de confinement, j'ai appris que l'église est composée de personnes ayant des capacités et des compétences différentes. Seuls, on n'est pas très utile, mais ensemble, nous créons quelque chose de très beau. En servant, nous créons une perspective de gratitude et cela nous permet de ressentir la paix et la joie qui découle de l'obéissance.
Besides the skills I have learned, serving at HIF humbles me and such a joy to serve in my father's house. I get to build meaningful relationships with my teammates as they were able to reach out to me during my time of need during the pandemic. Thank you so much, HIF. God bless you all.
We're not only blessed with experienced team, but we are blessed with volunteers who have the heart to do God's work for His glory. We are so unified in our diversity, and every week we learn and things got better. The overall online response from HIFers and the HIFers in the diaspora was really encouraging, and we are so thankful that we've had the opportunity to use this platform to be able to reach out to the people of Hanoi and beyond. Praise to God.
Well, as we look back at this past year, we have so much to be thankful for and to celebrate. Too much to mention, but I do want to highlight a few other things. In October, the HIF Football Club won for the first time the Love Hanoi Football Cup. In November, we co-hosted with the Evangelical Church of Bangkok the first international church exchange with HIF staff and volunteers joining together with three other international churches. And then later in November, the HIF African Band performed at the HIWC Bazaar and also at the International Gospel Music Festival held downtown at Hanoi Evangelical Church. And then in February, HIF became an Alpha Hub and hosted for the first time a regional training for Alpha. Also later in February, HIF launched a workplace discipleship initiative equipping believers to walk out their faith in their workplace. And then in March, our Connect groups continued online during the isolation period. In April, the elders said farewell to Kuang, she is on home leave, while we said welcome to Kester and Hardwick as new elders. And then in May, we baptized 6 more people with a total of 13 new believers being baptized at HIF this past year. Well, we have so much to be thankful for as we look back over the past year, but one thing I want to highlight is how God has provided for us financially. Typically, during the December season with Christmas and New Year's holiday, when so many people travel, it is a low financial month. But this past year, God provided more than double what we needed, and we were wondering why at this time. It wasn't until recently that we realized that God had provided for us in advance for the COVID-19 season. That the fat month of December, so to speak, provided for the lean months that we have now experienced. And so it's so amazing that over these past few months, we were able to give out more than what we have experienced in loss. We gave over $7,000 to the different hospitals and $4,000 to more than 70 people in HIF in need. And we only experienced a loss of 2% in our budget, amounting to about $7,000. And so right now we are on a tight budget. We are on a minimum budget for the summer. We're monitoring our expenses so that we can see if we can regain ground again. And we ask that you would pray with us and that you would give alongside of us so that we can sustain HIF as we have restarted all of our programs. So that's it for a celebration Sunday. There's so much to be thankful for, but I'm just thankful to see God at work in and through HIF to glorify God among the nations through Christ-centered worship, genuine relationships, and transformational outreach. Oh, one more thing. It's our 25th anniversary coming up. Well, obviously through the pandemic, a lot of things got delayed and postponed, and so also our planning for the anniversary. And so we've decided to delay this and start from square one in August and celebrate our 25th year anniversary over the next year and have a joint event later in our next program year. So really looking forward to that. And thank you again for volunteering, for serving, and for giving. God bless. Thank you.